Okay, welcome back. Our next guest is teaching crochet to Bedouin women in Israel and helping them make money by selling their creations. We're joined by Tal Zur, and also we have Nate Stonehill, who's going to be coming up after to talk about travel trends. But first to you. All right, first of all, I read up about what you're doing, and it really, truly is amazing. How did you come up with crochet as a form of creative expression?
Thank you. Actually, we started 2 years ago. My partner is Shula Moses, and she's a very, very good knitter. She has the idea. She wanted to create a social business that will based on crochet knitting. Then we searched a bit, and we discovered that crochet is one of the world's maybe unique craft that has a language, it has international signs. It means that if I'll teach you to knit, I won't teach you a specific item, I'll teach you a language with letters.
Right.
So if we have a language, we can communicate. So it actually helps us to overcome distance, languages, cultural difficulties, and so we can, you know, when we speak the same language, we can communicate. More than that, if you made a mistake with crochet, you can unravel
it
and fix it very easily. So actually, you won't waste material, you won't be afraid to make mistakes. So it, I think, all together makes the crochet is like the best technique and to work with, and I love it because it's everything is handmade and you can feel the textures and the yarns.
So it's very unique. So what made you go into this community in particular? Is it like one particular village, or you just go and you do programs in different Bedouin villages?
We work with the Chura. It's in the south of Israel. It's we work with women there, but actually IOTA is a method. I think that we can offer this method everywhere, anywhere else. I mean, we can go and teach women all over the world that are looking for a job, unemployed women, that we will teach them, and then they will crochet our product, and then they will earn honest living.
What an amazing way to also build just confidence, you know, for them, and to feel like their work, because listen, we all have creative abilities, and for them to be able to, you know, have someone who's there to inspire them and help them sell it. I mean, how do you help market the products? Like, do they have like fairs, festivals, online?
We participate in fairs and festivals. Like we participate. We started a year ago. The first fair that we were was in Design Week in New York.
Mm-hmm.
It's a
oh,
fair
wow.
in
How
New York.
Cool is that?
It was a year and a month ago. Afterwards, we participate in Maison Objet. It's a big fair in Paris, and we're gonna participate there again this September, and then. I think 3 months ago, it was we participated in Salon de Mobile with Tom Dixon. He offered us to, he's a very well-known designer, a British designer, that offered us to be in his space in the Salone. So we work with fairs, but we also work, because we control the production chain, so we work with architectures and interior design that we can customize our products by their needs.
Amazing.
So that's, I think.
So, what kind of change have you seen within these women since you've started doing this? I mean, are you able to, you know, have a relationship with some of the women in particular that you've seen really blossom?
I think first we are in a very good relationship with them. We know their families, we know their kids. We go there once a week, so we know them very well. We text each other, I guess, every day. So we're in a very good relationship. More than that, I think that. From our side, one of the things that was important to us is to teach them a skill. I think that everyone needs to be good at something. It doesn't matter what it is. I mean, you can bake the best apple cake, or to take the best photos, or, I don't know, drive very well. I think that to be good at something gives you power.
Self-esteem.
That's it. So I think that more than that, they use this technique and they do things for their houses. I mean, they need blankets for the kids, they need covers for the pillows. I mean, they use the technique for many things that are not related to IOTA, because, you know, when you teach someone a skill, it stays theirs, it's not our anymore.
Sure.
So that is the main. I mean, that was the main idea. We wanted to give them a skill that will stay their own.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming in, and it's such a beautiful thing. I was saying
thank
I want
you.
To send one of our correspondents, our cultural correspondents,
thank
to come
you. Thank
and,
you so much.
And meet some of these women. So thank you very much.
Thank